I am Tamil Rashid, Head of Generative AI Innovation and Delivery at AWS. Join me as I talk to leaders and innovators across Amazon who are using AWS Generative AI to create hyper-personalized experiences for customers, streamline operations, improve productivity, and so much more. Learn more inside Gen AI at Amazon. I'm really excited today. I have a guest, Jean-Luc. Welcome, Jean.
Thank you. Happy to be here.
Tell us a little about yourself and what you do at Amazon.
Well, I've been at Amazon for a while, 14 plus years now. Started a long time ago, back in Europe, and then moved over to the advertising team in 2012.
Okay.
So today I oversee mainly our creative building capabilities and our advertising formats across a number of different advertising solutions that we offer.
Okay, that sounds great. You know, we've had a tradition at Amazon to use AI and machine learning in many parts of our business. And as I understand, Amazon Ads has been using AI quite a bit throughout the years. Can you tell us a little bit about that?
You know, it's funny because AI is a really loaded term, in my opinion, and I think a lot of people share that sentiment. We've been using machine learning, deep learning, all of those type of technologies for a long time. I remember the early days of advertising, whether it's for sponsored products or sponsored brands or other type of advertising solutions that some of our customers might be familiar with.
Yeah.
AI has been at the core of a lot of those innovations and solutions.
Well, that's really great. How do you use generative AI within your team?
So what's interesting about this question is we didn't think of it in terms of how can we use generative AI, but rather starting from an actual customer problems that we were facing.
Mm-hmm.
A lot of our advertisers were running into a very concrete and real challenge. They did not have advertising creatives. They didn't have images. They didn't have videos that would allow them to go create the advertising campaigns that they wanted to.
Mm-hmm.
So that was 75% of them were telling us, I just can't do it.
Yeah.
It's too expensive. It's too difficult. I don't have the skill set or expertise. And so that's when we saw that problem and then we saw the rise of the capabilities of generative AI, we saw a match. We saw that there were capabilities that we can start building that would allow us to shatter those barriers for them to be able to access an advertising solution that they couldn't before. So last October, a year ago, we released Image Generator, which is a generative AI capability. And it's a very exciting, a very simple one. You give us a product detail page on Amazon, something that you sell, and in the click of a button, we can generate 4 stunning images that you can use in an ad campaign. And if you don't like them, you can just regenerate. We'll generate 4 more. And it's all free. All you got to do is then attach them to an ad campaign and run. And we've had tens of thousands of advertisers using that capability and are using it in live campaigns today.
Yeah.
And in this last Unbox, which is the Amazon Advertising conference, we announced Video Generator, which allowed us to actually create videos in the same context. You give us a product, and we can create a video for that. So we're really excited about the type of capabilities generative AI offers that make their life of customers way simpler.
Yeah. I'm so glad you talked about, you know, it's not about how do you use generative AI. It's really going back to the use cases, right?
Yeah.
And for the most part, understanding what persona are you really empowering with generative AI. We talked to a bunch of customers from that perspective, which is taking a persona view. By adding generative AI, how are you giving that persona superpowers, number one, and how are you actually helping them be more productive in the work that they do? I wanted to switch gears a little bit and talk a little about the technology underneath. So
sure.
AWS has a variety of different services to help builders build these Gen AI applications. Can you talk a little bit about what services you use and how you use them?
We're heavily leaned into AWS services for sure. And we've, over the years, constructed a number of different solutions around AWS solutions in general. For this one specifically, it's really, or I guess for the generative AI ones in that we've been so far, it's been a collection of different services. We used Amazon SageMaker, we've used some versions of Bedrock, Amazon Bedrock, we've used some versions of Amazon AWS Titan as well. So we're iterating on all of those structures. And what we found to be incredibly exciting is the flexibility that this offers. We can go test something really quickly. If that doesn't flow and doesn't work, we can quickly revert back or add some new services. And it allowed our engineering and science team to move incredibly fast. That's actually the topic of one of our talk at AWS reInvent coming up. So if you're going to be in town,
I'll definitely be there. I'll definitely make sure that I attend it because I'd love to learn more about it. No, that's great. You're using different parts of the platform to be able to build these applications. As you think about the metrics, like the metrics that you measure to see how effective the investment in GenAI is, has the team started to think about, you know, what those metrics are, what kind of outcomes you're looking to drive, whether it's efficiency gains or just reducing cycle time with, you know, ad campaign creation?
Well, we've thought specifically around customer experience metrics and how can GenAI help with those. And so, for instance, we're thinking in terms of the time it takes to create a campaign, the time it takes to generate those assets, the quality of those assets, how those assets end up performing specifically in the context of ad campaigns. So we're thinking through all of those different aspects. Still very early days, but I can say for sure that the faster we can generate an asset, the better.
Yeah, absolutely. You know, building these GenAI apps, it's on the bleeding edge of a lot of these application capabilities that are being introduced. But a lot of the work also goes back to foundational work, right? So how the data platform is set up, what sorts of security and guardrailing mechanisms you build around it, right? What sort of considerations went into that, either as you were pursuing these or prior to pursuing them?
Well, there's a number of, I want to say, learnings on that space for us, for sure. And what was interesting is, as we were seeing a rapid increase in the capabilities or at least the desire for us to build those capabilities, we realized that having stringent guardrails around privacy, security were absolutely critical. And I want to say that in the most honest context. This isn't just a PR or a legal requirement. We saw it as a core customer experience requirement. We saw it as a way for us to understand better the prompts and refine the prompts. We saw it as a way for us to evaluate the models and test the outputs of the models. We saw it as a way for understanding better how the customers actually intended to use the tools and what they're trying to do. So it really built a lot of new knowledge for us around that space because they have that rapid iteration and the almost conversational aspect of the interactions customers will have with those models.
No, I'm glad you really referenced that because there are a lot of lessons to be learned as people create these bleeding edge applications, right, and introduce them into the core apps. As you kind of look at the path forward with how to expand on the great work that you're doing already, what are some areas you're thinking about as a team as far as functionality or capabilities that you want to add, you know, in the future?
My, there's so much. Whether it's, you know, ideas coming from our engineers, our scientists, or our customers, we have quite a collection of ideas in flight. We just, as I mentioned, rolled out Video Generator, and we're going to be scaling it as fast as we can. We have new ideas like starting an image and then animate that image.
Okay.
And so we call that live image. And so how do we take that and use it in a context of an advertising experience? We have other ideas like you already have a video that's on your product detail page. That's maybe a 10-minute unboxing video. Well, can we have an AI watch that video and then provide a summary that we can then use in the context of an ad if you want to?
Yeah.
And so we're actually seeing generative AI as a way to start blending those different types of media, whether it's image and video, and try to create an experience that would be beneficial to the shoppers that will interact with this ad, and that will create performance for the advertisers. And so all those different ideas are coming together, and generative AI has been an enabler for both innovation and invention within the team and within our interactions with customers.
You know, it's amazing how this technology is just opening so many doors for creativity and, you know, just kind of reinventing and reimagining the experience that many people go through in building applications, but then also the experience that customers get on the other end. So it's pretty fascinating. Well, I do want to thank you for the time that you and the insights that you shared with us. I definitely look forward to attending your reInvent talk here in Las Vegas in just about a month or so. Thanks once again.
Thanks for your time.
Thank you.